Hello learners, today we are going to discuss course code 508, that is learning in art, health and physical and work education at elementary level. So our today's unit is unit 6, that is meaning and significance of health. The learning objectives: after studying this and after discussing this lesson, the student will be able to understand and explain the concept of health, describe the different aspects of health, understand the importance and significance of health for individual, family and society, understand and explain the relationship between health and education. So let's discuss the concept of health. Health is a complex entity which tells us about efficiency of a living being. Health is not merely the condition of being free from illness, injury or pain. It is your overall state of wellness on all levels of your being: physical, social, emotional, mental and spiritual. So let's discuss the origin of word health. The word health was derived from the old English word health, which meant a state of being sound. In order to maintain optimal health, it is compulsory to have a well-balanced lifestyle, which would include a nutritious diet as well as mental and social well-being. As it is shown in this picture, that if you want to get a good health, one should exercise daily, one should have a sound sleep and should have a good quality of food, which includes the green vegetables also. The World Health Organization defined health as a state of complete physical, mental and social well-being and not merely the absence of disease. The major key factors that influence the health are education and literacy, physical environment, biology and genetics, culture, income and social status, employment, working conditions, healthcare services, healthy child development. So now let's discuss the first aspect of health, that is physical health. Physical health can be defined as an essential part of overall health of an individual, which include everything from physical fitness to overall wellness. A good physical health means any external part of our body functions properly as it is commonly supposed to function. It also indicates wellness of our internal body organs and systems. Now, the second aspect of health is emotional health. Emotional health in this context includes one's ability to appropriately express their emotions, their ability to learn, and their ability to have meaningful social interactions and connections. Emotional health can lead to success in work, relationships, and health. Happy people are more likely to work towards goals, find the resources they need, and attract others with their energy and optimism. Mental health is a state of well-being in which the individual realizes his or her own abilities. A mentally healthy person can cope with the normal stresses of life. He or she can work productively and fruitfully and is able to make a contribution to his or her community. The importance of maintaining a good mental health is crucial to living a long and healthy life. Mental health can enhance the joy of living also. If we talk about mental wellness is based on some of the following factors, that are critical thinking, problem solving, creativity, education and learning goals, ability to adapt to change, ability to access resources, mental status and abilities or challenges. A successful mental health program should help children in learning to love learning, testing themselves, helping them learn to improve, develop their ability to concentrate, study skills, problem solving, knowing when to take a break. So, the fourth aspect of health is social health. Social well-being is a very important part in creating and maintaining a balanced and healthy lifestyle. Some components of social wellness include the caring and healthy relationships you have in your life, your social network, your level of safety, your housing situation, your level of interdependence, and if you are willing to accept and give help to other people, positive interactions with your community, that is volunteer work, your acceptance of diversity, it means accepting people regardless of their ethnicity, gender, sexual orientation, ability or religion. A successful health program should help children in learning how to communicate so they can be understood, how to deal with peer pressure in a realistic way, building confidence and trusting themselves, how to honor differences while respecting one's own point of view, compassion and empathy for others. Now, the next aspect of health, that is spiritual health. Spirituality is unique to each individual. Your spirit usually refers to the deepest part of you, the part that lets you make meaning of your world. Your spirit provides you with the revealing sense of who you are, why you are here, and what your purpose for living is. It is that innermost part of you that allows you to gain strength and hope. A successful spiritual health program should help children in exploring not just a relationship with God, but also with their own sense of divinity and greater purpose, and discovering a sense of priorities outside of the physical realm. This is a process that can work within or completely without formal religion. So let's discuss the significance of health. Health is an invaluable part of human beings' life. Without it, people can become uninspired, demotivated, and unable to thrive for success. So, some individuals visit their doctors regularly to make sure they are in perfect shape. Likewise, there are those who purchase insurance coverage so they can receive the best health care should there be a need in the future. Then there are individuals who spend a lot of time and money to improve their health by going to wellness spas, beauty treatments, working out in gyms, and buying healthcare products, among many other things. Significance of health for individual. How health is significant for an individual? Let's discuss this. There are several advantages of a healthy life. Our body will be free from various forms of health problems, and thus we will get a longer life. We can live a life without suffering from aches, pains, and discomfort. Kids' health is important for proper growth and development of their mind and body. They require enough energy to spend the entire day in school. They should be able to focus in the classroom and fully participate in the activities on the field. For this, they need proper nutrition, which include carbohydrates, proteins, calcium, minerals, etc. So, what is the significance of health for family? The family as a social institution evolves its own emotional atmosphere. This emotional climate may have either a constructive or a destructive effect upon the child's health. Healthy relationships in the family provide the opportunity for the child to develop stability and grow emotional maturity. Let's discuss the significance of health for society. When a person does not keep himself healthy, it can affect how he accomplishes his function to society. For instance, if he keeps getting sick, it will hamper his ability to do his work because he will keep on calling in sick. This would cause a chain of reaction. The productivity of the company he works for will be negatively affected by his absence, and in turn, his reputation will be impacted. He may end up losing his job also. So, let's discuss the relationship of health and education. The relationship between health and education is a complicated one, with a range of potential mechanisms shaping the connection between education and health. Some explanations of these relationships are: poor health leads to lower level of schooling, since poor health in childhood is linked to poor health in adulthood. Increased education directly improves health. Poor health and nutritional status of children is a barrier to attendance and educational attainment and therefore plays a crucial role in enrollment, retention, and completion of school education. So, let's discuss what are the effects of education on health. Education does not act on health in isolation from other factors. Income is another very important factor that interacts in many important ways with education as influences on health. However, empirical investigations often find that the effect of education on health is at least as great as the effect of on income. This would cause a chain of reaction. The productivity of the company he worked for will be negatively affected by his absences, and in turn his reputation will be impacted. He may end up losing his job because of his sporadic attendance caused by being sick a lot of times. It also helps promote and sustain healthy lifestyles and positive choice, supporting and nurturing human development, human relationships, family and community well-being. It is also important to emphasize that to the extent that education affects on health occur as a result of impacts on features of the self, particularly self-concepts and attitudes, then if the quality of education is not appropriate to the developmental needs of the individual, education can have directly injurious effect. Effects of health on education. The relationship between child health and schooling are very complex, and indeed there are multiple distinct relationships that are of potential interest, including the production function for academic skills, standard demand functions, and conditional demand functions. It is very important, though not impossible, to credibly estimate the relationship between child health and education. Thank you.